Hello, my name is Jo Stenehjem. I'm a postdoctoral fellow here at the Cancer Registry of Norway. I've been working on this postdoctoral project for the last 3 years under the mentorship of Dr. Trude Eid-Robsam.
And I'm Trude Eid-Robsam. I'm a senior researcher at the Cancer Registry of Norway, and I'm PI of this project.
Previous studies have been looking at anthropometric factors like body mass index, body surface area, weight, height, and weight change at the same time of the diagnosis as the melanoma. And they also only looked at thick or thin melanomas, the dichotomized, but we wanted to look at it as a continuous variable. So we therefore conducted a prospective analysis where we used measurements many years before the diagnosis of melanoma, and we associated that with a continuous variable of Breslow thickness.
Previous studies have been conducted in French and Italian populations, who are different from Norwegians with regard to phenotype, ambient UV exposure, and sun tanning habits. So how did we do this? Here at the Cancer Registry, we have a population-based cohort called the Janus Cohort. It consists of about 300,000 people. They were recruited during the period 1972 to 2003. And they were all in the 40s at enrollment. Height and weight were measured at enrollment, and they're linked to the Cancer Registry for cancer information. And they were followed for melanoma throughout 2014. It's 3,000 melanoma cases that have occurred during this time, and we have information about Breslow thickness for 2,530 cases.
Well, so what did we find? Well, we found that body surface area, body mass index, and weight were positively associated with Breslow thickness. And we saw that both in categoric analysis and in continuous analysis, where we used restricted cubic splines to model the curve and the shape of the association. We did not find anything for height, though. But we did also look at these associations stratified on anatomic site and on histological subtype, and we found that the association seemed, well, at least they seemed to be restricted to superficial spreading melanomas, the most common one, and melanomas localized on the trunk.
And as found in previous Norwegian studies, we found a higher proportion of thick tumors in men. It was about twice that found in women. This could result from a higher tumor growth rate in men, or it could be due to a lower tumor awareness, so-called patient delay.
So we know that the lower awareness could lead to delayed diagnosis. But why? What are the factors explaining the lower awareness? Well, some studies have shown that obesity and dissatisfaction of their body could lead to seeing the doctor at a later stage, which in turn allows the tumor to grow unnoticed, and then will be diagnosed at a later stage with a higher tumor thickness, that is, a thicker melanoma.
So why is this study important in a clinical setting? Well, we find an association between thick tumors and overweight. So overweight people have thicker tumors, and doctors might give overweight people, and in particular men, and a special or more thoroughly skin examination to identify malignant moles earlier.